So, hi guys. I know I have not been doing anything much lately. Cut short, my 3D printer was out for 2 weeks. I have a backlog of orders, artifact magazines came in, artifact stuff came in, so I've not been producing stuff or I can't produce stuff because I have no printer and I was too busy with artifact stuff. And I've also started to build my Gundam, so not really been doing Nerf around much. So, I'll be doing a few vids over the next course of maybe 1 month. I'll be making another vid right after this video. Right after this, I'll be going over to my bed. It'll be about the FPS vid, that FPS video. I know Sight has made a version of it, but now I'm gonna make my own version of it, a more in-depth version. So anyway, this video, cut short, it will be about this guy. Many of you, I met this guy like 3 years back. Back in those days, whereby 3D printers weren't really accessible to pretty much anyone in the world. This was my masterpiece, Airblaster. I'm really proud of it. I mean, looking at it now, I'm actually kind of proud of what I could achieve back then when I had no 3D printer. So, what in short, what this is, you can see in the title, it is my AT3KC. AT Red 3K or whatever fucking name I call it. In short, it's an 83K air tank that's reinforced, that's placed in a retaliator shell that is clip fed and runs on LiPo battery and compressor and external hand pump. This blaster has gone through rounds and rounds of modification and upgrades and over again until I keep improving it. So if you guys know me back then, you can see the picture back then. It was a really, you guys oversee call it a sleeper bridge, your so-called a sleeper car, whereby internals are actually fully modded, but externally you can't tell it's modded. When I started with this guy looked like just a brass bridge, retaliator. No one could tell what the mod internals were, but actually way back then it was already 83K internals. But over the course of modifying and bringing it to games, I modify it over and over again to be more suited for gameplay. So I'm just gonna move my camera over to here, and due to you guys' request of Zoko, how do you do this? How do you do this? How did I manage to make this blaster? I'm just gonna, you know what? Fuck it. I'm just gonna show you guys. I'm too lazy to reply PMs. So those of you guys who want to know how this is made, I'm gonna show it now. Okay, so here's the blaster. I've already prepped it advanced, unscrewed everything. So many of you guys asked how did I make this guy, so I'm just gonna show you guys the internal. So this is just half a shell. Screw this, my 3D printed top rails, nothing, no much of a big deal. So this is what you guys always wanted to know. So in short, this is just a Topic hand pump. For bicycles, yeah, for us motocross bikes or whatever you call it. This pump can goes up to about 120 PSI. Yeah, you can see the brand over here. Yep, sorry for the chrome effect, but yeah, it's a high pressure pump up to 120 PSI. For you guys that don't know, in Singapore, at least for me, I usually pump up to about 70 minimum, 70 PSI. So you can see here, the tubing goes into a T-joint. Then let me hold everything down and goes out. Just a screw. The rear here. Yeah. Oops, sorry. So it goes out to the rear and goes into a check valve. And here is a second check valve. So I'll come to the second check valve later. So it goes to here, goes through this check valve, goes up here, and then goes back inside the shell. So you guys are gonna ask where it come down from. See this tubing here? Right here? It comes down, follow to this tubing and goes inside the tank. So now that we have reached the tank, this tank is an 83K tank reinforced with fiberglass and epoxy. Now comes to the tank. Now these two white pieces, okay, this guy has been further modified after I've got my 3D printer and after my designing skills were a bit better. So this is two just 3D printed brackets or holding mounts to make sure the tank doesn't move back. Okay, then comes to OMW, what is it, metal recon boat slat that I have did some modifications to it. As you can see, it's a bit shorter. I will go from rear to the front. So this is, see this tube here? This is just actually one of those air tubing that I cut down to length. And the trigger here has been slot in a slot. This is an Explorer X trigger. I use this because I like the Explorer rubber padding. Drilled in two screws, perfectly straight. So goes into here, slot into the tank, and then just sits right there. So when I trigger off, oops, sorry, almost pushed my compressor down. So when I trigger off, you guys can see that it actually pulls off my tank. So this is a direct, what I would call is a direct trigger. That means there's no lever, no nothing. It's a one-to-one motion. So levers, triggers aside. This cable is connected to the rear radar buttstock. This is just Velcro book lace. I don't know what they're exactly called, but those are book retainers. Took to cut it down, and then you can see the wiring inside. These wires up in, okay, this point plugs into here, runs the compressor. Compressor is in the buttstock. The full shell is redesigned, a few shell work. Then here is your another wire that is connected to the compressor, or rather this wire assembly, which is your LiPo battery, at least my LiPo battery, which I just Velcro on and just plugged it in and then hook it up to the rear here, and there goes the blaster. So now comes to wiring. This wire goes down below the air tubing, goes to these two switch. Now you guys may tell that maybe people tell that these two switch, if I'm not wrong, they are scavenged from Stampede's, if I'm not wrong. I think they were Stampede's switches. So what these two switch does that I don't think anybody else has done so far for a clip fed blaster is that these two are my safety switches. Safety switches being that this is a mag sensor. So only when a magazine is slot in, this will be depressed. And only when there's a mag inside that's depressing this, and my bridge is fully forward. Okay, see this piece here? See the stock dart gate? Okay, sorry. See that's being depressed? Okay, only when the bridge is fully forward and the magazine is pressed, then I'll have a full closed circuit. So, yeah, so whenever I prime my blaster forward, okay, just so you guys can see, whenever I prime the blaster forward, the bridge opens. So, in Singapore, or at least I call it the barrel moving bridge. I'm not sure what overseas what you guys call it. But whenever I push the blaster forward, okay, push it forward, the bridge opens and it pumps. So whenever I close it, the compressor cuts off and I'm ready to fire again. So that's pretty much how the compressor two safety switch system is being linked up. If I do not want to run the compressor, I can just off the compressor and just run hand pump going full silent, because I have been taken out a few times because people can hear where I was from the compressor farming. So the barrel is a 916 brass. This black tape is because of an extension. My barrel is actually this short, but I extended the barrel out. Just a play around. So I've taken my trigger out. I'm going to show you guys the whole bridge assembly. Okay, I like to design my stuff, at least my air blasters, to be interchangeable, or rather swappable, because air blasters are not the most reliable of blasters, but some may go say that I'm wrong whatsoever. But anyway, I like my things to be so-called interchangeable. Like for example, if my tank explodes or I break my tank, the whole bridge assembly is actually removable. Okay, and my tank is just actually detachable by this. This is a quick release, so the moment I lift this up, okay, I can just pull my whole tank out. It's a total separate system. Let me just see if I will. Yeah, anyway, I'm just gonna show you. I'm not gonna do it. See this blue piece? I can just pull it and then the whole thing just comes out. Okay, then the tubing, as you can see, the tank is movable. The moment I release the tubing, my whole tank is removable. So if in case any of my this tank does blow up, all I have to do is just remove this copper brass piece This is a 1732 brass into a 916 brass, so it gives it the 100% seal. So the tank can be just swapped out anytime whatsoever. So here comes the bridge design. Obviously, not kind of obviously, I'm not going to remove the full bridge system because I'm too lazy to, but you guys get the idea. The bridge is closed like this, and when I push the boat sled forward, like how the normal priming position is of a retaliator, the bridge opens. So this piece, this white piece, is actually a 3D printed so-called bridge reinforcement or design to make sure that the front of the bridge, because the barrel and the bridge, the feeding system itself, is two separate pieces. If you do not align your barrels properly, right, there will be a lot of misfeed, a lot of dart chewing and whatsoever. So I actually created a PVC version of this bridge guide, or yeah, I will call it a guide, bridge guide design, so that it clamps the 2 point down out with PVC. But after I got my 3D printer, I went ahead and designing with 3D printing. So this, once again, is removable. Let me just remove it. Okay, so as you can see now, the whole front muzzle is removed. The whole bridge is removed, but due to this black tape, I can't. But you guys get the idea. Yeah, see that I can just slide all the way forward. Tell you guys what, I'll just remove it to show you guys. Hope I didn't black tape. Okay, never mind. I black taped a lot, so I'm not going to remove it. You guys can see the whole bridge, if I just take out this pipe, I can just slide the whole thing forward. So you guys can tell that my whole design had a concept back then. I mean, my whole concept back then was that if anything breaks, I can just go out and swap, go home and swap. And the part that broke, I don't have to rebuild a full blaster and whatsoever. So yeah, this is pretty much my Retaliator 3K. Two switch mechanism, as you can tell. One simple switch, and the other one, it's okay, you guys can also tell I cut a slot inside here, so it clears the other top switch whenever it is being depressed. Yeah, so that's pretty much how I made it. Really straightforward, but I've yet to see someone replicate my work. Maybe after this video someone will. I know you guys are going to say this is no big deal compared to Liam Davies' work. I'm really a fan of his work. Too bad for us in Singapore's HPA, high pressure air, normal air, it's a controlled item and I can't get access to it. Because if I had, I would frankly do exactly the same thing as what Liam would do, a full auto system. But too bad here in Singapore, we are not allowed to play with such stuff, or rather we can't play with such stuff. So yep, that's my ClipFed 83K. I'm just going to show you. Lift up the tank, slot the rear part of the guide back in, pull down the rear the duct gate, close the bridge, and there you have it. The whole bridge is back in. The shell covers, forgot to put the other half of the shotgun grip. So yeah, I did modify this stuff to work with the FF 5111 F10555 Retaliator shotgun grip. Give me a sec, I just need to make this piece back in the boat's sled position. I know you guys must be thinking right now, look, wow, Zorko, your mod is actually not that simple to get it in. But actually, it's really simple. It's just that this piece right now is being a bitch and it keeps flipping up. Just lift this up, go inside the freaking hole. There. So you can see this bronze screw piece is back in. And yeah, close the whole blaster up. So I know my shotgun grip is here. Okay. But you guys should be able to tell if you screw on. This guy back then was running the stock Retaliator cover piece, but you guys can tell. Yeah, you guys can see just by holding the piece. You guys get the concept of how the blaster works. So yeah, I'll be doing a video after this with this guy. So those of you guys that want to see how the internal system is, there you have it. Thanks for watching.